Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars.
Let me explain why the last day of the month is truly the best time to buy a car. It sounds like folklore, but it's not folklore. It's true. There are a lot of things that contribute to that. Let's start with the manufacturer. The manufacturer values market share very much. And when they are monitoring their sales for a month, and the industry, the dealers and the manufacturers monitor their progress by 30-day cycles. Every 30 days, they win or lose. It's like a boxing match. One fighter wins and the other fighter loses. One manufacturer wins, the other manufacturer loses. If it's Toyota and Honda, if it's Ford and Chevrolet, everybody's got their Lex Luthor that they're fighting to try to come out on top. So they pour on their advertising, they pour on their bonuses to dealers, they pour on their incentive money to customers, and that is focused toward the end of the month. The focus of the advertising brings the customers in toward the end of the month. So people come in droves, and the salespeople understand that, and the manufacturers understand that. Now let's move to the dealers. The dealers incentivize their salespeople based on volume, and the volume, of course, peaks at the end of the month because 30 days is the defined cycle for the dealer's financial results. So a dealer might have an incentive if you sell 10 cars or more, or 15 or 20 or whatever the incentive is. So let's say a salesperson's got 9 cars out and he gets a $1,000 bonus on his 10th car. You can see how hard he's going to try to sell that car on the 30th day of the month. He'll sell a car and make very little profit because the $1,000 bonus is more than he'd ever make as a percent of the profit anyway. Sales manager, he's incentivized by the same method, volume, and the volume peaks at the end of the 30-day cycle. There's even something called stair-step incentives, which General Motors and Ford and Toyota and a lot of other manufacturers are getting into. Now, a stair-step incentive is a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing for the buyer. It's a terrible thing for the customer. It's a good thing for the manufacturer because it does maximize sales, and it especially affects the end of the month because the dealer has a bonus incentive. Let's say the dealer has to sell 200 cars. Now, if he sells 200 cars in that 30-day cycle, he might get a $500 per car. Now, that's $100,000 when he sells that 200th car, if he's got a 200-car objective. Now, you can imagine how low a profit a dealer would authorize to be taken at the end of the month, because the $500 per car is retroactive to all 200 cars he sold. You could sell a car for below actual cost, or you could give a car away. I'm not saying that dealers give cars away, but they could and still come out ahead of the game. So this is all the reasons why the last day of the month, and it doesn't have to be literally the last day, it could be the next to last day, or maybe even the third from the last day, because that's really when the frenzy starts, the last 2 or 3 days of the month. Now, with that said, let me warn the buyers. Don't ever go in and buy the car on the last day of the month because you think you're going to get a good deal, but you haven't done your homework. Start doing your homework at the beginning of the month. Research the car. Check consumer reports. Shop dealers on the internet. Use all your sources of information. Be sure that you know what car you want to buy. Road test the car. Take a demonstration drive. You can go into the dealership. You can get pricing information. In fact, you can even get prices. You just don't have to commit and sign on the dotted line. But when you've gathered all that information, you're sure you got the right car, you've decided probably which dealer you want to buy it from, and you put it on hold. Let's say you've finished your homework by the 20th of the month. You know, take a little vacation. And on the 30th of the month, go back in the dealership and say, you gave me this price 10 days ago. It's just not good enough. I've gone to two other dealers, and I've gotten better prices. That's the time where they'll slash that price and cut it because they want to hit all the things that I talked about. The manufacturer wants to hit their incentive. The salesman wants to hit his bonus money. The sales manager wants to hit his bonus money. That sale to you might be a $100,000 bonus to that dealership. I have seen cases where I have sold cars for below my actual cost, and other dealers do the same thing. I'm not talking about the advertised below cost, because all dealers advertise they sell cars below cost, and obviously they don't do that very often. But sometimes, at the end of the month, dealers will sell cars below their actual cost to make a deal. So a dealer fee, I always advise people to negotiate the dealer fee this way. You want an out-the-door price. You're talking to the salesman. I want an out-the-door price. I want that to include tax, tag, and everything. I want to be able to give you a check and get in that car and drive home. Now, you've got a dealer fee. I understand that. I want you to absorb that dealer fee. Leave it on the vehicle buyer's order, the invoice, but roll it out of the price. Take the dealer fee out of the price and then leave it on the document. That way it's a wash. I'm happy, you're happy. You said you didn't waive the dealer fee. They will be much more likely to do that at the end of the month. So that's the reason that the last day of the month truly is the best time to buy a car. Earl Stewart.